Hallo und herzlich willkommen Mittwochabend wieder mal. Und wir sind live auf Twitch für euch heute wieder mit Sean Shelton und keinem Gast, weil wir haben ganz viel zu erzählen und wir haben vor allem ganz viel zu reden mit Sean. Hi Sean.
Hallo Paul.
How are you doing?
I'm good.
Yeah? How was your day?
It was good. I had a MC lecture.
Sean ist ein Vortragender für Englisch für Ingenieure am Management Center Innsbruck, für die, die es nicht wissen.
Genau. Our proud partners. That was a good video that they made. Yeah. A really good video. Or that we made together, I guess. And then did a little work on the bathroom. Cleaned up the training facility a little bit. And now I'm here.
Perfect.
And what I mean by work on the bathroom, I guess we're renovating my wife's house. So that's what I meant. Not, yeah.
Yeah. Schöner Start, glaube ich. Mm-hmm. Also, Sean hat einen schönen Tag. Ich hatte auch einen schönen Tag.
Oh, I didn't ask. How was your day? Sorry.
Good.
Yeah.
I mean, just a normal office day. People came, people went back. And now I'm here with you for the Twitch show. You lost weight, Uncle Charlie says.
Thank you. I actually have.
Yeah.
And I think it's the haircut a little bit. That's what my wife told me, at least. When I have a round head, or excuse me, when I have a round hair, it makes my head look round.
Yeah. And I heard that gray is also a perfect color for...
I thought it was black.
And gray. Gut, Freunde, wir haben heute viel vor. Wir haben viele Neuigkeiten, über die reden möchten mit euch, die letzten Tage rausgegangen sind. Wir haben ein Q&A gemacht auf Instagram, wo ihr uns Fragen geschickt habt, die wir natürlich alle beantworten werden. Wir werden über unser Virtual Combine reden und wir werden natürlich mit Sean ganz viel über seine Entscheidung als Quarterback Number One in die 11 für die Swaco Raiders zu gehen reden, wie es zu dieser Entscheidung kam und wie die Zukunft ausschaut für ihn und uns und euch und uns alle. Ja, so ist der Plan für heute. Wir machen es wieder so, ihr schreibt einfach rein, wenn ihr Fragen habt, wenn ihr was wissen wollt. Wir werden heute natürlich viel Englisch reden. Wir hoffen, ihr versteht das alle. Wenn ich was übersetzen soll, dann bitte einfach reinschreiben. Dann kann ich gerne auch nochmal auf Deutsch wiederholen. Aber ich glaube, Englisch im Football hat sich schon sehr durchgesetzt und werden hoffentlich die wenigsten damit ein Problem haben. Gut, wir fangen immer an mit General Infos und General Notes über die Raiders. Was ist so die letzten Wochen passiert? Ehrlich gesagt, außerhalb natürlich der Planung für die neue Saison nicht viel. Ja, also wir haben die Nachwuchssaison beendet, über die haben wir das letzte Mal gesprochen. Basketball läuft weiter. Wir hatten ein großartiges Cup-Spiel gegen die Swans Gmundne, First Division Team. We lost by 30, I think, but it was a good experience. Antworte ich gleich. Und dann hatten wir letzte Woche ein Auswärtsspiel in Salzburg, was unsere Jungs gewinnen konnten. Am Wochenende steht das nächste Auswärtsspiel in Klagenfurt an. Klagenfurt auch der Finalstandort für das Elf-Finale nächstes Jahr. Und ja, Basketball läuft und der Rest ist in der Offseason / Lockdown / Break. Ja. Leider ist der Breitensport zurzeit nicht erlaubt. Das heißt, viele unserer Mannschaften, gerade im Fleckbereich, haben verordnete Trainingspause. Die anderen Nachwuchsteams ruhen sich noch ein wenig aus und können dann hoffentlich... What's the plan? When do they start?
Hopefully we start back up December 13th, but at the moment we've taken a recommended pause. It's probably best for everybody to take care of yourselves.
Und für die Situation in Österreich, die ist nicht ganz einfach. Und da wollen wir natürlich auch unseren Beitrag dazu leisten und jetzt nicht unnötig große Gatherings machen. So schauen wir aus. Dann würde ich auch vorschlagen, dass wir gleich zur ersten großen Neuigkeit eigentlich war es, weil auch wenn davor viel drüber geredet wurde, it was a big news. It was also a long process for you to make this decision. Mm-hmm. And I would say we probably start with this little video we made about your decision. And 2020. We have to wait to not watch some stupid Werbung. Und jetzt zeigen wir euch ein schönes Video über Sean Shelton. Number 12, Back in Black, war der Titel des Videos und ist, glaube ich, eine schöne Beschreibung darüber, dass Sean nächstes Jahr für uns
Austrian Bowl
nächstes Jahr für uns unser Quarterback sein wird. Mhm. Besides these impressive stats through all the last six seasons, I think this video really showed you as a player. It was a good combination of how you were present on the field, and I think these stats were only the AFL stats. It didn't include it.
Maybe the international stats. Could be.
So these were just one part. Impressive career for now. Mm-hmm. And we had the moment with this Austrian Bowl, with this epic Austrian Bowl in July here in Tivoli Stadium, which could easily be the ending of this awesome career.
Yeah.
Because it was an epic game, rain, the lights.
Obviously, everything lined up, right?
Exactly.
I mean, a home Austrian Bowl against the Vikings, done.
With a win.
Over. Well, yeah, of course, with a win, and an awesome win, right? Like a dominant win, and it was a storybook ending, and I was done. I think everybody saw it. It's like I had a hard time containing myself. In fourth quarter, you know, and post game or whatever the case may be, it was a perfect ending to my career, and I was very happy with that. I was very satisfied with that, and then things changed.
Things changed. You say it. In the summertime, I mean, there were already rumors in season, and obviously, already 2020. We got somehow attached with the Elf. Why are the Raiders not joining the Elf? And then there were talks with the Elf. And then through the summertime, things got clearer and clearer. And when was the moment in August, in September, when you were with your head in youth football, when was the moment and how was it when you thought, maybe there is still a little fire in me?
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, the rumors in the summer, you know, I wasn't privy to that at all. I remember you and I had a conversation. Paul and I were talking in the stadium after maybe a game or a practice, whatever it was. And we started talking about the Elf, and I actually lost a bet with you.
Yeah.
Because I was like, there's no way, you know, it wasn't in my vision or peripheral vision or anything. I didn't think it was realistic. And then we had a board meeting, some of the leaders of the team and you know, our football department was brought in to talk to our club leaders and club management, and they said, hey, we're thinking about doing this, and we've had several meetings, and it sounds like an exciting opportunity. It was like, okay, I was wrong, Paul was right. But at that point, even then, it was like, hey, this isn't realistic for me. I don't know if this will work, and mainly from employment and some other things. And Claudia actually pulled me aside after the meeting and said,
"Side note: Claudia is our general manager for the whole club, and obviously she makes the decisions too."
Mm-hmm. And she pulled me aside and said, "Hey, what do you think?" And I was. After the meeting, he was like, yeah, this is great. I think this is the right decision for the club, but I don't see myself being a part of it. And via conversations with Claudia and Kevin over the next few weeks, it was like, okay, maybe. And then the more I chewed on it, the more the competitiveness took over, right?
And right in that time, it was probably the moment when we had the Twitch show and you got asked about it and you said, yeah, it's an interesting thing. It's in competitive league. It's something new. You're a competitor. You might be interested.
Yeah, I think.
And people made out of this statement, people said, oh, he's playing.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe they knew better than I did. But the point of that kind of, of course, I want to play in the ELF, right? Of course, I wanted to play at the highest level. Every competitor does, and anybody who deems themselves a good at something wants competition. So that was what that statement was mainly. But I didn't know if it would work. And, privately, I didn't know if it would work. You know, Lisa and I had made a ton of plans for me not to play. Obviously, we've moved away from Innsbruck. We're doing a big renovation on her family house. And the plan was to stop playing. it was for years that, boom, done. But there was something that just was in the back of my mind that was like, hey, you'll regret this. I think you'll regret this. I think I just kept picturing myself standing in Tivoli VIP, if I got a VIP ticket, maybe in the general stands, being in Tivoli and watching an ELF game. And it just didn't work. I couldn't grasp it. And then it was really when it was announced that it was this fire came out, and it was like, yeah, no, I can't pass on this opportunity.
Perfect. I think with this decision you give us as a club, I don't speak for everybody, but for me as somebody of the club, a former player, I played with you, you give us, it's a security thing, mm-hmm. It feels good. Mm-hmm. It's I think also for the coaches, for the board, for everybody, for the fans, we know you. We know, and we just saw it, he can play football. he obviously can, and pretty good. And going with you in that season, I think, is a big step for us and is a big anchor in that team.
Well, and that was part of the motivation. Obviously, I want to play as a player, Sean Shelton as a quarterback, and see if I can take the success that I've had in the AFL and apply it to higher leagues. But also, I always have a giant desire to help the success of the Raiders in any way possible. And if that's as a player, great. And if it's mutually beneficial, it is great. But the success in the ELF is something that's really important to me for the club. And anytime there's a new transition, if you can keep as much continuity as possible, I think that's vital.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then the decision was made. Other news came out. We were going to talk about it later too, about our conferences and stuff mm-hmm. like this. Mm-hmm. But we are now in beginning of December, 1st of December. What is the actual status, or status is maybe the wrong word, what are you guys doing right now? What is the football team doing? What are you doing right now? Because you are involved also a lot into recruiting mm-hmm. and scouting somehow mm-hmm. and making or giving your advices and thoughts about future Raider players. Mm-hmm. So what is your daily business right now? Once as an athlete and member of the team, as a player, and also part of this whole organization.
Yeah, I think at the moment, for me personally, it's really just being a resource for Kevin and Coach Kevin. And their main task and Coach Kevin and his scouting department's main task is kind of evaluate where our roster is at the moment and evaluate what additions we need to make put together the best, 53-ish man roster that we possibly can. And that's no easy task. It's a whole new world for us. In the AFL, we didn't recruit. Not really. We didn't. There was no need to scout.
Because of the rules.
Because the rules and we had two Americans and we brought in three but could play two on the last several years and that's all we did. And now it's kind of opened up an opportunity for us to bring in two more Americans and play two more Americans and then have these eight European spots that, Yeah, it's really a brand new world, and it's really, really exciting. It's really, really exciting. It's really, really cool to be able to try to piece together a championship-winning roster, which is ultimately the goal.
The goal.
And so that involves a ton of communication, a ton of planning, a ton of evaluation, and that's what we're doing at the moment is deciding what pieces we need to add, evaluating potential prospects at that position, contacting those prospects, and seeing what their availability is, what they would need, what is their plan and their football future, and seeing if it's a fit, and that's time intensive process. But it's really, really exciting.
You see a lot of players, you can actually recruit. I think that's something cool, talking to future players.
Yeah.
Yeah, just meeting new people, getting new information, it's a cool thing.
Exactly. And I really think the Raiders, I mean, I'm 100% biased, but I really think the Raiders are a really special place to be. And if you genuinely care about football, if you're extremely passionate about football, there's not a lot of other places on the continent that can offer this football paradise, is what I call it. And to be able to find guys that you think are fits and share with them this thing that you've been enjoying for 7 years now is also really, really cool. You know, it's like when you recruit guys and you contact guys, it's like, oh, man, you know, it'd be awesome. Yeah. I see what you guys have. You know, we made a virtual tour and showed our facilities and met some people and stuff like that. And it's really a football paradise. And like I said, if they're Europeans that genuinely care about their development and are just crazy about football, like our Austrians are, to be honest, it's cool to be able to share that with them and make like a bridge for them to live their dream, like I have. And that's really exciting.
Cool. The ganzen Fragen, all the questions we're going to answer after we're done with the interview with Sean. So don't get mad if we don't answer immediately. You said it's a football paradise, mm-hmm. yeah, for somebody who cares about football and wants to reach probably the highest level. If you can pick 3 points, what makes Innsbruck the paradise from a football player view? What can our organization offer? What is the difference from us maybe to others? Just 3 points.
I think the main one, there's two main ones, and I'll think of a third. The two main ones are, there's no combination, in my opinion, of facilities and personnel. Mm-hmm. So we have literally everything, equipment-wise, facility-wise. I mean, our new training facility is unreal. It's the best training. I mean, as an American, I never had anything like that. And we have our U6 training on it. They have no idea. I played on a terrible grass field with holes and it's really a luxury. It's a blessing. And when you combine that with personnel who know what they're doing, that's a dangerous combination, because some guys have great personnel. And I think there's a couple clubs around Europe that have facilities, maybe not comparable to us in terms of this $7.2 million training facility combined with Tivoli, combined with Olympic Lifting Center. But those things aren't in itself of value unless you have the personnel.
Ooh.
Yeah, having Pro Andy as a strength and conditioning coach, having a professional coaching staff, having a Nachwuchs coaching staff of 6-7 deep that are passionate. That's, I think, the combination that makes the club special. And then if you would ask a third, it's the support of a very, very stable, passionate main sponsor, which I also think people take for granted.
Who trusts in the process
of
the
people. Who genuinely loves the club, involved with the club. I mean, she probably wouldn't be super happy about me saying this, but I've been to her office on multiple occasions in her professional life, and it's just Raiders stuff. I mean, to have that kind of support from a Hauptsponsor, it's a deadly combination that I just don't think many clubs can compare.
Without being like picky or negative, it's just the perfect.
No, it was.
I mean, a couple of years ago, we were also practicing on an old grass.
Exactly,
it's football field.
It's been a progression. Yep. You said shitty, by the way.
Sorry.
We practice on a field over by a farm when they sprayed cow they sprayed pig poop in the middle of the practice and your clothes stank for weeks and your hair. You know, we've been there.
Yeah.
But as of lately, the development of this club, it's turning into a perfect storm at the moment.
I think that's a good point. The combination of these three things makes us really special. And we can say that we're going to get a lot of requests, and we're very happy about it, that so many most likely players, but also coaches are interested in our club and want to join. And we get so many requests about internships on the management side. Even we got somebody wants to do an internship he's from France in our medical staff or medical department. So it shows that people are going to see how good we are.
Yeah. And then lastly, I would say our homegrown players are very, very special. The culture that has been built.
This Raiders culture.
This Raiders culture is also, you know, I've heard it from other imports coming here. It's like, it's different here. Yeah.
Okay. So season going to start in June. Of course, we're going to have camps before that. What are your, obviously, the goals are easy. I can answer them. Mm-hmm. Going to win it all. That's always our goal. But how do you progress this upcoming season, and what is your goals, maybe also individually?
I think from an off-season standpoint, I would really, really like to get back in like college shape, but it's going to be really difficult, and maybe that's unrealistic, and it's my body's changed drastically since I've been 22. It's just the way it happens, right? And maybe it's more of a Tom Brady core bands approach, but I would like to personally, at times I felt unexplosive last year, and it wasn't so much that I was heavier. I wasn't, although people said I looked heavier. It was more so training change, body change, and everything like that. So trying to figure that out and get back to as close to peak performance as I can is really a personal goal of mine. And then in terms of the season, we have some camps in March and April to try to whittle down this roster a little bit and figure out who are the guys that we're going to take to this new adventure. And then once this starts, you know, I don't know. I really never set personal goals. Mm. I don't.
Not how many touchdowns you're going to throw, but like I said, of course, everybody wants to win it. Everybody wants to be in the final, and at the end, when you are the winner, that's the best. But like, how? Because it's completely something new. Maybe a little bit. What is your goal to approach these new? Because you're what is the word? You're in major. No, is it major? Erfahren. When you've done things a lot.
Experienced.
You're an experienced veteran player. Mm-hmm. We're going to have new guys. We're going to also have new long-term football players, maybe never played in Tivoli when there are 5,000 fans. So what do you think is maybe also your goal and your task as a leader and an experienced veteran of that team?
Yeah, I think it won't change that much from year to year. You know, on any given year, and I genuinely mean this when I say it, and it might sound arrogant, but it comes from a place of really love, is I want to be the best quarterback for the Soccer Raiders in the world. And that's my ultimate goal. There's nobody who can do the job here better than me. And that not only includes being a leader of the offense, which I think I took huge strides in my leadership last year. You know, I wasn't a guy who really talked much, to be honest. You know, when we played together, I wasn't outspoken. Mm. I tried to organize the offense as best as possible, make sure everybody was calm and knew what they were doing. But I wasn't a vocal leader. It's never something that I felt comfortable with. And at times last year, I felt like I needed to be, and it was important. And so I took strides there. And then also being the resource that I've always tried to be in game planning in the office, to kind of peel back the layers a little bit. You know, every Tuesday, I help put together the game plan with the offensive coaching staff, and I'm kind of a part of that and put together, you know, I scout the next defense, the next opponent, and try to put together a game plan that makes the most sense and what's relevant for us and what I feel comfortable with. So I've always tried to be involved in that, and I always try to get better, come up with new ideas and develop that with Kyle, and we've come a long way with that. make sure practices, you know, it just on everything that I can positively influence in terms of game planning, leadership, general quarterback play and understanding of everybody else. I try to do that at the highest level, and that won't change this season.
And then we're going to see what is the outcome
of all these things. It's going to be extremely interesting.
Es wird extrem spannend, und bevor wir in die Saison starten, ist noch viel Arbeit zu tun, und eine große Sache hat Sean schon angesprochen, und das ist das Recruiting und das Scouting, und da möchten wir euch gerne etwas zeigen, was, correct me if I'm wrong, I think that's special for Europe and have never been done in Europe.
Not that I know of.
Me neither. Especially not in football. So, was wir euch jetzt zeigen werden, ist aufgrund der Pandemie und des Lockdowns und natürlich auch unserer gesellschaftlichen Verantwortung wurde unser Combine letzte Woche abgesagt, und wir haben es geschafft, mit zwei unglaublich guten Organisationen, und zwar einfach einmal Europe's Elite und natürlich der Gründerfirma dieser Seite, GMTM aus den USA, die virtuelle Combines vor allen Dingen in den USA für Colleges anbieten, unser Combine durchzuführen. Und Sean, you were heavily involved in that thing. Maybe you can talk a little bit about it and show it to the audience.
Yeah, it was an unfortunate scenario. You know, you always want to do things in person and have it here. And Coach Kev and Caleb came up with a great plan with that. And it was going to be really well structured. And then unfortunate that we're in the situation we are. But you have to adjust. And the answer was put it on this platform, which is a really neat platform. And via Europe's Elite, we were able to make this connection and put it together. And it's everything that we would need to see or hopefully be able to accomplish in an in-person combine. So if you look at this intro virtual tour, if you click on participate, you can see a 17-minute tour that we do of our facilities.
General feeling of what it's like.
It goes through the whole facility, the meeting rooms, you meet Pro Andy, our strength and conditioning coach. So it goes through everything and gives a pretty good look at what it is in terms of our campus, what it looks like. And then Kyle explains his offense, his background, Kevin as well. And then everybody can put in their information there.
Personal data, yeah.
And then they can go to the individual positions or whatever position that they play. So let's say we're playing with a linebacker. Go ahead.
Question, why is there no quarterback?
I said the same thing. No, not
we have all positions.
We even put in specialists, which is nice. So you go to your position minus quarterback, and let's say you're a receiver, and then we had a bunch of guys come out here and film and demonstrate the drills that we want you to accomplish or film doing, and then that gives us a way to still evaluate you, and it, what I think is really cool is it still gives the players a platform to expose themselves to us.
Also outside from COVID and travel restrictions and stuff like this, it's a great chance for people, let's say, from Scandinavia not to spend hundreds of dollars to fly to Austria and be here for a day. With this, they have the chance to send in their data to make exactly the drills how they would do it here live. Of course, sometimes there are some maybe understanding issues or people do things differently. But for us or you coaches, you get an overall overview. Okay, that's this guy. Here is his personal data and here are his drills. And that helps so much, right? And
yeah,
then you
exactly
can go
right
into details and maybe highlights of him. And
that's exactly right. And so in the intro, they fill out a kind of a questionnaire to help us get to know them better.
Yeah.
You know, why do you play football, and general information to help us, get to know you better. But to your point, you know, I think it's something that we probably or might always do in conjunction with an in-person combine, because like you said, you know, our participants actually doubled when we
and
registered participants doubled when we went virtual because it's just more available. Yep. Anybody can do it. Literally anybody around the world can do it and expose their talents to us.
You don't need a football field and a 4K camera. Do it with your phone and three cones on the park.
The grass. Get mom or dad to go out there and film you from the stands. And have your brother, your cousin, or your sister come throw you a ball if you play offense, whatever the case may be. And anybody can do it, really. Yeah. And I think the point that you made is a really good point. It broadens our horizons in terms of scouting. And it's been a really, really good tool for us, and we've gotten a lot of positive feedback.
That's really cool. And if there are players and you want to register for it, just go on our homepage, Raiders.at, then search on the news page football, and then you're going to find this article about the virtual combine. Sign in, send your video, coach is going to have a look, you're going to get an answer, people are going to evaluate you, and who knows, maybe you're going to get a shot to be part of the Raiders.
Everybody has a shot. That's the cool thing.
So, dann fangen wir mal an, würde ich sagen, mit den ganzen Fragen. Wir haben jetzt wirklich viele Fragen hier auch im Chat reingekriegt. Ich scroll jetzt nach ganz oben. Danach gehen wir zu den Fragen, die wir aus Instagram bekommen haben, und auch aus Facebook haben wir eine, glaube ich, bekommen. Und das schauen wir uns mal an. So, was haben wir denn hier als erste Frage? Schon mit dem Vermessen des Stadions fertig? Nein, bei uns liegen nämlich gerade 50 cm Schnee. Also das machen wir dann, wenn es wärmer wird, dann vermessen wir das Stadion und dann wird das alles gut gemacht. Dann Frage zur 11. Hat man Überlegungen angestrebt, Sandro zu signen, wenn er nächstes Jahr keinen Platz bei den Giants bekommen sollte? Sandro is a Raider. You understood the question? Sandro is a Raider. If Sandro will not be part of an NFL team in the future after his third season, then, because he has one more with the Giants, so it would be then in 2023. I think if he comes back to Innsbruck, we would sign him, yes. If he wants to continue playing football. You never know what his personal plan is. I can't talk for him. Sean can't talk for him. I think he's working hard to be part of an NFL roster for the next month and years. And of course, Sandro is special. And if he's coming back to Innsbruck and he wants to be part of the Raiders, then he's very welcome.
There's nothing to think about.
Exactly. This is what I wanted to say in a longer version.
Yes.
So, the Goats. Danke, sind wir die Goats.
Is that D-Dubs? Is that...
It's D-Dubs.
I know a D-Dubs.
Welcome to the Central Conference. Darüber reden wir auch gleich noch, über die Central Conference. Do you already got more information into the elf, watching your opponents and get more familiar with the league? I think this is a question to you.
Yeah, I think in terms of watching defenses and game plans and schemes, no, but naturally in scouting you watch it. It's just the purpose is different, you know. When you're evaluating players, you're kind of focused on one or two people at a time, as opposed to, ooh, this concept might work. So more on a scouting base, we have plenty of time to evaluate concepts and try to prepare from schematically what to do. So yes, but maybe not in the way your question was framed.
How long do he plan to play?
Yeah, I'm done. I'm so done planning. Every year is something different. It's
you can't.
2022, I'm playing.
Who knows? Life. You can say yes and no. Who knows?
Yeah, I mean, 2019 was supposed to be my last year. It's every year. Yeah, life is unpredictable. Yeah. I'll say it that way.
Andy Zoner, danke für dein Follow, den ich da übersprungen habe. Dankeschön. Looking forward to come to Berlin and play Björn Werner's Thunder. I think the Thunder make a really, really good move in signing Björn Werner as a sports director, and I think he's also involved in the management, because Björn has his own, how you call it? It's not an agency, it's a service. Mm-hmm. He's bringing young players. He also brought Raiders kids to the States, and this since years. So over years, I think Björn built a pretty good database of European kids who are in the States or already maybe done in the States and coming back now to Europe. So I think he probably makes some good signings. And especially, I thought that they signed Kyle Kitchens from the Leipzig Kings. And he was a pretty impressive defensive lineman, and that's a big upgrade for them. And Berlin is always a cool trip. Berlin is special, and yeah, looking forward.
Yeah, I mean,
but I can say the same about Stuttgart and Frankfurt.
I'm excited for all of it. Yeah. So,
wird es einen Fanbus zu den Auswärtsspielen geben? Also, in der Vergangenheit haben wir immer bei vor allen Dingen besonderen Spielen, wie zum Beispiel Spiele im europäischen Bewerb, aber auch Finalspiele von der AFL, Fanbusse organisiert. Und das ist immer ganz stark davon abhängig, wie das Interesse bei euch Fans ist. Wenn das Interesse da ist und diese Busse gebucht werden, dann werden wir das immer zur Verfügung stellen können. Wenn natürlich sich nur eine Handvoll findet, dann ist es schwer, das als organisierte Form zu machen. Aber ja, es ist unser Wille und auch unser Wunsch, dass wir unsere Fans zu den Auswärtsspielen mitbringen können. The Istanbul Rams seems to have a good facility too. Yes, they have. They have a good field on their university campus. And I just saw the video that the owner, I think, of the Rams or of this university, that they build a new soccer football stadium where the Rams can play then too. So, yeah. Im Mai wird die Saison starten. Klappt ja sonst zeitlich gar nicht anders bei 12 Spielen plus 2 Bye-Weeks und Länderspielpause. Ende Mai, Anfang Juni wird das erste Spiel sein, ganz genau. Werden viele von der AFL-Mannschaft aussortiert, beziehungsweise steigen welche nicht in die neue Liga auf? That's maybe a question to you. Guys from the old AFL team.
Mm-hmm. At the moment, I don't know of anybody in particular.
And we don't say names here.
No, I wouldn't say it anyways, but I think everybody's genuinely excited about this new opportunity, new league. Maybe some guys are hesitant or skeptical just because it's something new and they need more information, you know, whatever the case may be. But I think in general, everybody's really excited about it because, again, if competitors want to compete at the highest level.
Yeah. Werden die Raiderettes wieder dabei sein wegen dem Unfall letztes Jahr mit den Cheerleadern? Also den Unfall in der Elf? Muss ich ganz ehrlich sagen, habe ich nichts mitbekommen, was da in der Elf und den Cheerleadern passiert ist. Das soll jetzt bitte nicht falsch verstanden werden, aber wenn das irgendwie am Game Day war, wo vielleicht Spieler reingelaufen sind oder sowas, vielleicht kannst du das kurz reinschreiben, Dominik, aber auf jeden Fall, wir haben viel Erfahrung mit Cheerleadern an Spieltagen im Stadion und haben eigentlich noch nie einen Unfall gehabt, der jetzt nicht unbedingt daherkam, dass eine Cheerleaderin vielleicht bei einer Pyramide umgeknickt ist, abgestürzt ist, oder es sind ja immer Leute da zum Auffangen, aber es ist jetzt eigentlich in den letzten Jahren oder seitdem ich bei den Raiders bin, seit 2009, nie ein Unfall mit Cheerleadern und Footballspielern passiert. Aber vielleicht kannst du uns das kurz reinschreiben, Dominik, was da passiert ist, weil ich bin nicht darüber im Bilde. Und ja, absolut, natürlich werden wir unseren Fans eine geniale Show bieten und da sind natürlich die Raiderettes ein Teil davon. What do you think about the new kickoff rule? Gute Frage. Und da schauen wir uns doch mal die neue kickoff rule an, für die, die es noch nicht gesehen haben. Da gibt es nämlich ein ziemlich cooles Video, was die XFL gemacht hat letztes Jahr. Und das schauen wir uns einfach mal an und dann können wir ja mal darüber. Spannend. Spannend. Als ich das erste Mal gesehen habe, habe ich gedacht, oh, als kickoff return team, you're gonna need 10 offensive linemen, because they know how to block on short yardage, in short distance. So that's the chance for the big boys to be on the kickoff return team.
Could be. I mean, it's almost like a bunch like stock blocking from receivers.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or, you know, but then maybe there might be schemes where you run like trap plays and stuff and pullers. And, you know, I have zero experience with this. I'm very intrigued by it. But, you know, I don't think there's been a ton of injuries that I can remember specifically from kickoff and kickoff return, although I do know there's big collisions. And this will really help that in that regard. Not that it was an overwhelming problem, but at least not in Austria. Or
maybe the injuries were not like a torn ligament or something. It was probably more these full speed body head to head collisions, which I mean, I can remember a play where our returner showed the fair catch signal. The kickoff guy didn't saw it or interpreted it differently and just blowed him up. Mm-hmm. He was so, yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe you can remember them when Enno.
Yeah.
So it's for the safety of the players. And I think everything for the safety of the players, every new rule is good. And I think after 1 year or one season, the league, the commissioner going to evaluate it. Does it make sense? Does it not make sense?
Yeah.
I would, because I saw a little shitstorm also online.
That's twice, Paul.
Yeah, isn't that the English word?
Yeah, but
you a poop storm.
A poop storm. I said ass, and you got mad at me.
Yeah, a poop.
A big poopy storm.
A big poopy storm against that rule. Aber ja, würde ich mich gar nicht so viel aufregen. Das ist ein Play quasi. Also das ist ein.
No, I think you can look at it in negative, like. They're changing football, but you could also look at it positive, that it might be something really exciting and cool and safer, which is ultimately, I'm really more curious about the execution of it, you know, because it also said, you know, I think it makes sense that nobody can run until the ball's caught, but it also said, unless the ball has been, once it hits the ground.
3 seconds.
3 seconds.
That's probably a little bit different for the referees. Are they blowing the whistle?
Do they have a timer when... Because it also eliminates, one thing it might do is it might eliminate squid kicks or sky kicks. Like, does the ball have to travel over the 30-yard line? You can't do sky kicks. You can't do squib kicks where you just kick the ball on the ground. If the ball doesn't go that far.
What happens then?
Like, I'm more interested in the execution of it. And like you said. Onside kicks, which are a part of the game.
Onside kicks?
And where does
I think everybody is waiting for the rule about the onside kicks. Maybe the onside kicks are just going to be normal because on onside kicks, the distance between both teams is about 10 to 12 yards. Depends how they line up, but it's at least 10 yards.
Mm-hmm.
So the risk of high speed, hard hitting is not that high. So maybe the onside kick stays the same.
Could be, but then do you...
There are different kinds of onside kicks.
When you declare an onside kick...
Surprise onside kicks are probably not possible anymore.
That's another thing. So
you take something away of... Yeah.
Yeah. So, like I said, the execution of it and how it kind of changes the dynamic is something that I don't know and I'm interested to find out.
Yeah. Wie schätzt ihr eure Konferenz ein? Konferenz machen wir ganz am Ende von allen. Man spricht ja schon von der Todesgruppe. Ja. Ein Footballspieler ist in die Pyramide reingelaufen und dann waren die Beteiligten verletzt und jetzt dürfen anscheinend keine Cheerleader mehr am Feld sein. Das ist natürlich tough, wenn das passiert ist. Es gibt ja einen Sicherheitsabstand. Natürlich kann es immer passieren, dass jemand weiter rausläuft und dass dann Dinge passieren. Habe ich jetzt noch keine Informationen darüber, wie das nächste so auszusehen hat, aber ist sicherlich ein bedauerlicher Fall und wir hoffen, dass es allen gut geht. Sollte aber natürlich nicht passieren, weil Cheerleader auch wirklich, es gibt ja auch diese, I think the name is Press Zone, die ist, ich weiß jetzt gar nicht, wie viele Yards. No, in the Elf game.
Obviously. I see.
Probably a receiver or something, you know.
Yeah.
And then ran into. So, unsere Cheerleader sind sogar noch weiter weg als die Press Zone und wir haben auch immer eine Trainerin, also wenn ihr jetzt die Cheerleader wärt, ich schaue euch jetzt an, ich bin die Trainerin. Das heißt, die Cheerleader stehen mit dem Rücken zum Feld. Ich sehe als Trainerin, wenn dahinter was passiert und kann vielleicht sogar noch notfalls intervenieren. Aber wie gesagt, ist bei uns zum Glück noch nie passiert. So, did you think about signing an NFL free agent or a college player? Sean?
Yeah, I mean, all American players that aren't on a roster are available.
Ja. Welche Cheerleader machen während des Quarters Pyramiden? Ja, Ich glaube, wir lassen das Cheerleader-Thema mal beiseite. Die XFL hat ein Video, wie es in echt aussieht. Ja, kann man sicherlich nicht anschauen. Ich weiß auch, dass es von der ELF da noch was geben soll in Zukunft. Also lassen wir uns überraschen. Just made the virtual tour. Great stuff. Thanks, Coach Lichtenberg. There will be no surprise onside kicks. If a team wishes to run an onside kick, it must indicate this to the official before the play, and the two teams will permit it to line up using traditional NFL rules. Okay. Ja, also wie gesagt, ich glaube, das hat ein bisschen für Aufruhr gesorgt, dieses neue Kickoff-Scheme, und das ist ja auch gut so. Wir lassen uns überraschen. Wir sind neu, für uns ist alles neu, also ist es auch nicht schlimm. So, jetzt schauen wir rein, was ihr uns noch auf Instagram geschickt habt. Und zwar ähneln sich die Fragen natürlich ein bisschen. Sean, question to you. What are your plans if you stop, after you stop playing? Ja, what are your plans? Was sind Sean seine Pläne, falls er nach der Saison aufhören würde?
That is. Yeah. Well, the plan was to continue to work with the Raiders. And you know, I'm part of our football department. I run the NACFUCS program. I've coached U18 for the last 3-4 years. I've been a head coach in the NACFUCS program. And now obviously helping in terms of recruiting in the ELF, now that we have a new world, and all that stuff would basically stay the same. I'd be more available to do those things. But the plan would be, and the plan is continuing when I'm done playing, to continue my full-time employment with the Raiders and continue to care for the NACFUCS program and be a resource to the men's program. Mm-hmm.
Was glaubt ihr wird euer Field Goal Target sein, auch die 25 Yard Line?
What?
Marcus Askas.
What would be my field goal target?
Yeah, like.
Yeah, how far I could kick one?
No, not you.
Us. Ours, myself.
I'm not so much into kicking. I'm not sure.
I mean, in my opinion, we never kick field goals, so.
Exactly. We have a quarterback who scores on every drive.
Yeah.
How do we prepare against the new opponents? Yeah, like also, like in the past, we scout in a certain amount of time before the game. So in season, you obviously don't. You only have 5 days to to do your work, or four, because Friday you practice and everything should be done. Mm-hmm. And then it's watching film, scouting, doing scouting reports, preparing your team, practicing your plays, practicing against the scout team, and then playing the opponent. Und das wird natürlich alles dann mit den Camps beginnen, starting with the camps maybe.
Yeah, even beforehand, once the roster is started, or once the roster is kind of fixed, you know, I probably at the beginning of next calendar year, then you kind of, I think all of the coaches' focuses will shift on, okay, now what do I need to do to beat our new opponents, and scouting and learning the coordinators and tendencies and habits, and then, yeah, in week, it remains the same as it always has been.
Ja. Dann haben wir eine Frage von der Annalena, und zwar 11 und Ablauf mit AFL erklären. Also nochmal zum Verständnis. Wir werden zwei Mannschaften haben. Wir werden eine Mannschaft haben, die in der European League of Football spielt. Diese startet mit Ende Mai, Anfang Juni in die Saison. Und wir werden eine Mannschaft haben, die in der Austrian Football League spielen wird. Diese startet am 1. April Wochenende. Mit einem Tiroler Derby, so viel darf ich schon verraten. Es wird so sein, dass es einen Roster gibt für die AFL und auch einen Roster für die ELF. Wenn sich ein Spieler der ELF zum Beispiel in der Saison verletzt, dann darf ein Spieler aus dem AFL-Roster nachrücken, darf aber danach nicht wieder zurück. Das heißt, es ist nicht erlaubt, wöchentlich Leute hoch und runter zu schieben. Was natürlich passieren kann, ist, dass es Spieler, maybe there are players who start the season with the AFL, playing the first couple of game weeks, maybe are so impressive that the ELF coaching staff decides, oh, I want this guy on my ELF roster.
Could be. Could
Same be. Direction down. So there is a high competition right now between all these players. And yeah. Ansonsten ist es so, dass im Jahr darauf natürlich, oder dann in der Herbstphase, wenn beide Saisonen vorbei sind, die Roster neu gemacht werden, die Spieler werden neu evaluiert und dann werden die Roster wieder neu gemacht. Genau. Ich hoffe, das hat dir etwas erklärt, Annalena. Und dann haben wir auch noch eine, and that's I think it's not a question. Somebody wants that we invite Max Pichler zu unserer Show. Max ist ein ehemaliger Spieler, ein Defensive Lineman, der mit dem ich, meine Generation, mit dem ich sehr viel Zeit bei den Raiders verbracht habe, ein unglaublich lustiger Mensch und mittlerweile ein Defensive Line Coach in unserem AFL-Team. Und wir haben uns ja was überlegt, wo ich am Ende noch zukomme, und zwar unsere Weihnachtsshow. Und Max, wenn du das jetzt siehst, wir laden dich ein zu unserer Weihnachtsshow. Aber du musst entweder als Santa Claus, als Christkind oder als Grinch verkleidet kommen. Eins von den drei Sachen. Wenn du das machst, bist du part of the show. I didn't talk to Sean about it before.
No, so but I stand by that.
Also, Weihnachtsshow, kommen wir später zu. Gut, dann haben wir, glaube ich, alle Fragen durch, weil die anderen ähneln sich sehr mit der Kickoff-Regel etc. Auf welchen Gegner freut ihr euch besonders? Passt. Fliegt ihr oder wird es lange Busfahrten geben? Von Innsbruck fliegt nicht überall hin was. No. Wir werden sicherlich die ein oder andere Strecke mit dem Bus fahren, ganz normal, weil bevor man nach München zum Flughafen zum Beispiel fährt und dann nach Stuttgart fliegt, macht überhaupt keinen Sinn. Alles, was in einer vernünftigen Reichweite ist, wird auch aus ökonomischen Gründen natürlich mit dem Bus erledigt. Alles, was weiter weg ist, wo es dann auch wirklich um Zeit geht, die man nicht verschwenden kann, wird sicherlich auch Spiele geben, wo wir fliegen müssen. So, und jetzt kommen wir noch, bevor wir uns dann auch schon dem Ende langsam nähern, nochmal zur Conference. Und die hat natürlich für Aufsehen erregt, weil... Und das habt ihr Fans so da draußen beurteilt, sagt ihr, dass das die sogenannte Todesgruppe ist. They call it the Death Group. With the reigning champion Frankfurt Galaxy, the reigning AFL champion, us, then the Vienna Vikings as a high-class organization and always and last year's AFL contender, and Stuttgart. Awesome. You always want to play the best. And if you guys say these are the best teams, thanks that you count us in as the best team. And yeah, let's go. I mean, it's everything is new for us. Also, the Vikings gonna new look new and different than the times before. So the question about how excited we are against playing against these opponents, I can't really answer, maybe you. But if there would be Barcelona, Rheinfire, and the Centurions, I would say the same. It's not...
Yeah, and I think the other thing is, you know, maybe our fans might be a bit upset or whatever, which I don't think so. But as a player, do you really want a weak conference? Do you want to walk through it? You know, if there is a weak conference, I don't know. I don't know.
Weak, exactly. We don't know. We didn't play them.
No, I mean, there's two new clubs in the same, but there's also two new clubs in ours. It's just ours are established, and the Rams will be significantly different than the National League Rams before, and then Dusseldorf, I'm sure, will be good. So it's tough to say. I'm excited to see the Vienna Vikings in this new league, and I'm excited to go play in Frankfurt. I'm sure that's going to be an awesome environment. And, yeah, I mean...
No.
I don't read too far into it. You just don't know.
Exactly. Interconference-Spiel werden Berlin, Leipzig und
Cologne
sein. Genau. Also wir werden eine ganz schöne Deutschland-Tour machen.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking. Like, it's interesting because several years ago, way back, we were, you know, as a club, is even discussed. I don't know how seriously it was taken. Is potentially joining the GFL. And now it seems like the Vikings and us just joined the GFL a little bit. I don't know. I think their non-conference is obviously different than ours. But yeah, we'll be taking a tour of the homeland, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Leipzig is not far away.
Eating a ton of pretzels on away games. That's what you guys do.
You people.
You mean Germans? Yeah. We don't play in Bavaria, so in Frankfurt you don't eat pretzel.
I was at the Frankfurt Hauptbahnhof and I ate a pretzel. Because that's what you do. Yeah. You're in Germany. I mean, come on.
Okay, Freunde, wir kommen langsam dem Ende entgegen. Und ja, wir haben ja auch die Stunde schon wieder voll. Und es ist war unglaublich cool. Wenn ihr noch Fragen habt, postet sie jetzt rein. Und Sean, Spotify, what is your song of the day?
Ooh, I have a good one. And you just mentioned Bavaria. I think it's called Bayern. Des Sommer Meer.
Bayern. Mm-hmm. Des Sommer Meer. Sterne. It's a playlist.
No, it's a song too. I mean, it's the first one. It's the first one.
Is it?
Yeah. You want to play it real quick?
We're gonna play Sean's songs. We always play at the end. Yeah, you know, for the outro, we play it.
Yeah. Yeah. Is that the national anthem? Is that what it is? It's on my folks music playlist with Valentina.
You have a folks music playlist?
Valentina loves folks music. And she and she just bounces. So it comes on, it's like
Bayern.
Das Sommer mehr, genau. Jawohl! And Valentina's just and it's got stuck in my head, unfortunately. It's very catchy. Sei freundlich, habe ich gesagt. Jawohl! It's like, oh my god.
Auf welches Match freut ihr euch am meisten? Auf alle. Wir freuen uns auf alle. Gibt kein Special. Wird alles cool, wird alles neu. Ja, ich nehme und zwar von Krummer nehme ich der letzte Song Alles wird gut. Weil gerade vielleicht für viele Menschen nicht alles gut ist. Kleiner Song zum Nachdenken. Cooles Lied. Zieht es in euch auf jeden Fall rein. Wer noch nicht unsere Pirates Cove Playlist auf Spotify folgt, musst es unbedingt machen und ich teile euch jetzt auch den Link.
What an attractive playlist.
Awesome. Awesome. Also unbedingt reinhören, folgen.
I'm very happy you knew that song.
Me? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I have been to folks music of beer garden festivals and
Bayern, das Sommer mehr. Jawohl!
Ja, ihr Lieben, vom Luca noch eine Frage. Was haltet ihr von dem neuen Signing von den Vikings?
I'm sure he's really good.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of good football players in this league and he's probably one of them.
Yeah. And yeah. Going to be interesting to play against them. Going to be awesome for our players to face such great football talent. And for you fans, it's going to be really nice. And hopefully he doesn't make a lot of big plays against us. Or we just cover him good.
Just gotta make more.
That's yeah, all. Exactly. Throwing more touchdowns.
Yeah.
Ihr Lieben, wir werden uns nächste Woche wiedersehen. Aller Voraussicht nach nur mit mir. Und da werden wir so ein paar Kleinigkeiten machen. Vielleicht spielen wir auch mal ein bisschen PlayStation. Ja. Und schalten den Sean dann dazu. Und er muss kommentieren, wie ich Madden spiele.
Yeah.
Also wir lassen uns was Cooles einfallen für nächste Woche. Dann in 2 Wochen machen wir eine Pause, weil dann müssen wir uns nämlich treffen, um Ideen zu sammeln für unsere große Weihnachtsshow. Am Mittwoch, den, was ist das dann? 22.
Ja.
Ja, Mittwoch der 22. Jetzt schon mal eintragen im Kalender. Große Weihnachtsshow. Wir werden Special Guests haben. Vielleicht den Weihnachtsmann, vielleicht das Christkind und vielleicht Grinch. Vielleicht alle drei zusammen.
Or all three during the show. He has to come in, he'll get changed and come back in.
Dann werden wir Giveaways machen. Ihr könnt Sachen gewinnen. Wir werden geile Preise haben. Ja? Also gespannt sein, unbedingt einschalten. Unter allen Zuschauern werden dann coole Preise verlost und Merchandise-Sachen. Alles, was ihr... Also wirklich, seid gespannt. Ja? It's gonna be really cool. Und dann spielen wir vielleicht auch noch ein bisschen Madden oder so. Lassen wir mal. Wir werden es hier uns weihnachtlich machen. Vielleicht trinken wir einen Glühwein, essen Lebkuchen und dann...
You had a drink on the show?
Of course. It's not, I mean, alcohol-free Glühwein.
Exactly.
Gibt es schon Off-Season-Trainingspläne? Ja, natürlich. Die Jungs sind in der Kraftkammer, auf der Laufbahn, geben alles. Pumpen. Gibt's. Wird trainiert. Wir haben einen Strength- und Conditioning-Coach, der unsere Spieler mit Trainingsplänen versorgt. Und ja, Freunde, das war's. es ist 20.05 Uhr. Wir haben die Stunde voll gemacht. Vielen, vielen Dank fürs Einschalten. Vielen Dank für den Support. Vielen Dank für eure Fragen, euer Interesse an unserem Verein. Das zeigt uns, dass wir viele Sachen, glaube ich, ganz gut machen und euch das gefällt. Ja, gehen wir in eine aufregende Zukunft, was die Elf angeht. Und wir freuen uns drauf.
Exciting times.
Exciting times. Sean, your last words.
Exciting times.
Okay, exciting times. Dann bedanke ich mich fürs Einschalten. Es war mir eine Freude. Es hat sehr viel Spaß gemacht. Bleibt gesund. Schaltet nächste Woche wieder ein. Folgt den Raiders auf allen Kanälen. Unbedingt auch YouTube abonnieren. Da kriegt ihr auch immer coole Clips und Videos. Und dann sehen wir uns nächste Woche. Bis dahin, ich wünsche euch was. Ciao, Kakao. Pfierdenk.
Fine. I don't have pants on.
Where is the... I don't find the end. Here's the end.
Das haben wir mehr.
Jawohl!